our day 13 of Confidence Boot Camp. I'm sitting here in my backyard. You can hear and see my fountain. And this I call my meditation garden. I'm here like every night during the summer. I just love it. It's a very small backyard, but I planted it with flowers that I love and plants. And it's just green, and I kind of live in an urban area. And so my fountain kind of takes me out of the traffic that's in the background. Anyway, I'm happy to be here today to talk about today's post. We have a guest blogger. Her name is Carolina Millan. And the subject that we want to talk about today is around the concept of letting go of control, which is kind of a scary thing to think about for most of us. We feel like we have to be in control in order to feel safe, feel secure, and to have consistency and predictability in our lives. But here's the thing. Sometimes we have to let go of control in order to have control. And so today we're going to talk about how to do that. Let me tell you a little bit about Carolina. She, her story starts in Chile, where she was born and raised. And she grew up and then did what a lot of us do. After going to school, she got a job in the corporate world, working for someone else, having to work the hours that they tell us to work, with what, like a week off of vacation and, you know, a 401k, all of that stuff, which is all nice, and a lot of us do well with that. But some of us don't. Some of us want to be our own bosses. So that's what she did, and she quit. She quit her job. She had this passion and this idea. She loved to travel. She liked to speak, do public speaking, and she started her own business doing digital marketing and public speaking and personal coaching. And she is very successful now. She travels all over the world. She speaks to hundreds of people. She does personal coaching for both men and women. And if you look at her website, you'll see that what she does is pretty impressive and very inspirational. And it's her story about letting go and trusting her instincts that really is compelling. Because so many of us have a dream, we have a passion we want to pursue, but we don't have the courage. We don't trust ourselves. We worry about other people judging us, or about our own self-judgment. We worry that we're going to fail. All of this stuff keeps us from making the plunge. When we really we really need to find a way, whether it's working towards a new career or your own company, or doing something like writing a book, or learning how to paint, or for me, a few years ago, it was photography. I have always been interested in photography, and I somehow wanted to make that happen. And so I just bought a camera, and I started just trying. And I didn't know where it was going to lead me, but I knew it would lead me somewhere. And that's the thing to hang on to, is you might not know where, you know, plunging into the unknown is going to lead you, but it will lead you somewhere. And there's a good chance it will be somewhere that you'll be happy. For me, you know, my pursuit of photography, along with my love of, I'm a clinical social worker, and I love what I do. I love working with my clients. And I wanted to combine the two of them. And here I am now, working with my partner, Marilee Buchanan, and Megan. Megan is our business manager, and Haley Fields is our social media person. And we are doing this blog, and I'm able to combine my love of photography with my love of working with women and social work and inspiring women all over the world, and working with my leadership programs to follow their passions. So here's the exercise I want you to do. I want you to write your own story. Sit down, just let your imagination run wild. Act as if you have no limitations, that there's no worries about money, how this is going to happen, what are people going to think. Just write your story. Write the story that you want to live. See where it takes you. And then, after you've done that, think about who can you include in your story. None of us can do this by ourselves. We need support. We need help. We need to let go of parts of it that, frankly, we don't want to do. And Carolina talks about that in her post. You know, ask yourself, is this really worth my time to do this particular piece of this thing that I want to do? And if it's not, find someone else to do it for you. And then finally, surrender. Now, the concept of surrender is an interesting one. It has a pretty negative connotation. You know, we have visions of someone waving a white flag and just like giving in. And that's not what healthy surrendering is at all. Healthy surrendering is literally getting out of your own way, which we are our own worst enemies most of the time. And if we can get out of our own way, who knows where that will lead us. And that's what surrendering is about. Another technique that you can use is called thought stopping. So when we start hearing those negative messages in our head that inevitably come, things like, oh, who do you think you are for thinking you can, you know, write a book, or paint, or be a photographer, or ride a bike for 170 miles like I did this summer. Believe me, I did not think I could do that. You're not good enough, you're not strong enough, you're not creative enough, you're not talented enough. All those negative messages that we're constantly telling ourselves, we've got to get them out of the way. So there's a technique that we use in the therapy world called thought stopping. And it actually works. It's very simple, it's kind of silly, or it sounds silly, but it works. When you find your brain flooded with those negative messages about yourself, simply scream, yep, stop! Just like that, stop! And guess what? That will interrupt that flow in your head, and you'll stop. And at that point, you can look at it more realistically. And that's the process of getting out of your own way. For example, here's a more realistic way of looking at, let's say you want to write a book. Wow, I kind of want to write this book. I kind of have a story in my head. Maybe it's just a story about me. And I don't know where it's going to take me. It's going to take me somewhere. And I have a pretty good feeling that that somewhere is going to be a lot more satisfying than where you are now. So it takes a leap of faith, and it takes surrendering, and it in the healthy way. So give it a try. Try these things that I have assigned you to do. This is your exercise. This is your assignments for this particular post. Read up on Carolina's tips and her techniques and how she got out of her own way. And I think that you'll be pretty happy with the end result. And now I would like you to introduce you to my wonderful dog and my wonderful son, Nick. Say hi. This is Nick, who's been my cameraman. And this is Molly, who you'll also find on our blog. Hi, Cindy. And Molly wants you to know that she believes in you too. And we'll see you tomorrow for our next post. Bye. Wherever I'm going.